This is Cord. Cord came in reactive to humans, reactive to dogs, not knowing really any commands, and we just did some off-leash healing. Yes, he's on a remote collar, but this is the thing, and it's important for everyone to really, really know. If you've never used a remote collar before, and say your dog doesn't know what heel is or any other command, this concept that if you just start pushing buttons, the dog is going to listen to your verbal command, it doesn't work that way. In fact, I would challenge anybody to just put a remote collar on their dog that doesn't know a command, and then all of a sudden push buttons and it'll just miraculously start doing the command. Now that's a falsehood. Now, can you do that for, say, getting into the trash can? Absolutely. You make it uncomfortable. Jumping up on counters? Absolutely. Barking at the front window? Absolutely. But for healing, recall, sitting, downing, hours and hours and hours, like hundreds of hours go into that to get an off-leash heal. And I think that's the big thing. So especially that last scene with that jogger going by, that it would have been like a reactivity issue. Korg is also nervous by nature. That's a good title for a song. 1980s, you know, I think that would be like, I don't know, some big hair band, Nervous by Nature. I think this is what's really, really important is that this concept of that if you inflict discomfort on a dog when you're doing him obedience, it's going to do the obedience command. It just doesn't work that way. It just doesn't. Leash training first. Hundreds of hours of leash training. Then leash training around distractions, other environmentals, teaching the dog what the proper positioning is, teaching the dog that it needs to stay in that proper position around environmentals that used to make it explode. And how do you do that? Through obedience work, lots of hours of obedience work. So when people say that remote collar training is a quick fix, it actually takes longer to obedience train a dog on a remote collar. It actually does. And then if you look at Korg now, you're gonna see it's like, yeah, I'll just hang out here while Jeff's talking. I don't care. I don't care at all. And you know, when we talk about environmentals, it's like just being outside is an environmental. Obviously that jogger running by was a big environmental. There's music in the background. That's an environmental. There's cars. There's, you know, buildings. Right now, you know, Korg has the free will to get up and run. And I assure you, if I just was pushing buttons, it's not like the dog would automatically come back. Because when you've got a nervous dog, they actually don't know what to do. You still have to train them. So I think it's really, really important to understand that this doesn't necessarily train the dog. Training trains the dog. This is a communication device. That's all it is. And we can do this, and we food train too. We teach all the basics. We're family pet dog trainers. We stop bad behaviors and train good behaviors. So if you took food and the dog doesn't know down, and I had food, the highest value food there was, and I said down, the dog's not gonna just go down. You need to teach the dog what down is. So, you know, if I stand up, you know, I have not released Korg yet, but break. Korg, let's go. Good job. Good boy. Good boy, Korg. Let's go, buddy. Look at that. Heel. So, and you know, here's a great example where, let's say Korg is like lagging a little bit behind me. Instead of me popping the leash, I can pop the remote leash. That's a great example. What I did was I just gave a quick momentary stim of the remote and you saw Korg come up to me. It's no different than a leash. A remote collar, when properly trained on a dog, replaces the leash. That's what it does. It's an invisible leash, but it takes time. It takes hours. We did our food training already. That's why we don't use food now. I want the dog to be under voice control and use my remote as my backup. All right, Korg, let's go. Heel. There we go. That's a good job, buddy. So watch, he's a little bit behind me. I've got my invisible leash. Let's go, buddy, get closer to me. Okay, there you go. You know, I'm just gonna educate so many folks about, first you gotta train the dog without the remote collar, at least that's our philosophy. And then you layer the remote collar over it. But then there's an educational curve. And then you've got different personalities with different dogs. It's just so important that folks understand the methodology behind the obedience part of remote collar training and then the behavior mod part of remote collar training. Thank you so much for watching that video with Korg. We're really, really proud of him. If you're struggling even just walking your dog on leash, we've got some fantastic resources on our YouTube channel. Check out this video to see how to even start your dog on a non-leash heel. Stop that pulling now. Love you guys.